Away from that, the state minister for Kampala, Kabuye Chofatogabye, has told plastic manufacturers and recyclers to tap into the manpower of ghetto youth to collect all the dumped plastics and polythene bags in the city. During a meeting with manufacturers at the office of the Prime Minister in Kampala today, the minister introduced to self-styled ghetto president Buchaman. Solid waste management is increasingly becoming the biggest problem in many urban centers of the world, and Kampala is no exception. Research indicates that plastics contribute 37%, which forms the biggest proportion of waste generated in households. Most households dispose general waste by opening dumping, while 27% dispose of plastics by burning. Because of this huge challenge, the state minister for Kampala, Kabuye Chofatogabye, today decided to meet all the plastic manufacturers and recyclers to deeply look into new measures of effecting recycling of all the dumped polythene bags and plastics to save the environment but as well give jobs. The minister told the manufacturers to take on the ghetto youth, urging that they can effectively help in the collecting of all the littered plastics for recycling.
The upper Kampala, where we believe everyone is more enlightened, Naguru, Muyenga, and that is the garbage or the kasasiro we find in the trenches, blocking all channels in Kampala, and then we get another problem of floods and noise comes in. Emiala bajizibye. No, it is you who broke this miala, and then eventually. So, basing on this, I had to run to my friends. Today, we are opening up this friendship. You are the first line at the battle. You are the front fighters whom I have to come to, seek knowledge, seek information, agree to disagree on how to approach this, on the modus operandi and how to approach this menace before us.
He maintained that what he wants to see is a clean Kampala, free from all sorts of littering. Government also plans to set up recycling facilities across the country.
Produces 2,500 metric tons of kasasiro each day. What can reach Chitezi is just 1,400 metric tons. The balance of 1,100 metric tons remains in our homes, in Kamocha, in Chisenyi, in Chifumbira, in Namuongo, in Kasokoso, in Nakurabye, name it, Chivulu, Kagugube, and other areas. Serve one spirit in us and a brief, which you know again. My product is my waste. So as you are aware, I urge you to always promote the three R's which guide your product, your industry. Reduce, reuse, and recycle.
The ghetto president Buchaman said that there are 90 ghetto slum areas in Kampala and they are all full of the young people willing to work. What they need is to be provided with uniforms and equipment plus a good pay.
Employ all the ghetto youths in the ghetto. We have these groups are called the group is called Kawenjas. They are from the ghetto. So we have teamed up together with KCCA, with the Minister of Kampala, to help these ghetto youths in the ghetto to clean up Kampala. All we need, the challenges we are facing, we don't have where the place, these youths don't have the place where to sleep. We need the place where to sleep. We need minzans, and we need this machine called the plastic machine.
Plastic manufacturers and recycling industries in the country consume up to 600 metric tons of plastic waste a day. They made a commitment to step up the recycling so that the environment is kept safe.
It's hard to educate Ugandans on how to manage plastics. Plastics must be managed well. That's why the former speaker from KCCA was saying some people misuse these bags. Instead of holding this bag and you take it to a recycler when it's clean, it ends with that. And now the recycler is at the burden of buying soil, water, and all the dirty stuff. But we are trying to help Ugandans, and my brother Buchaman, when you go to the field, you will need to bring a clean kavera.
This story was compiled by Jaliet Namuaya for the news in Kampala.